Welcome back, everyone, to Six Ashes for episode 4. As you can tell, I have rented, or leased, T-Rex 600. And I've been cleaning up a little bit of the yard. It took a little while, but we can finally get back to field work here. I'm thinking about putting in a wood chipper here and making a few dollars. But back to farming. This field has completely been completely plowed now. Actually, I should see if I missed any spots. As, fruit type growth, soil composition, 51. A little bit of red there. Oh well. If it needs plowing a second time, I'll get it done. Not to worry. So, I also have a contract going in, I guess field 69 on the other side of the highway. Perhaps you saw that from the last episode. I'm just going to get the headlands done on this field, and then I will go over and continue that contract job. The field, or the trees in on this map are, some of them are being difficult. As you maybe noticed, a few of them are missing limbs. On other maps, when they have been sunk into the ground, shall we call it, I found that if you can cut a few limbs off, go out of the game and come back in, they will pop out of the ground for you. But on this map, they just, they're not doing it. Perhaps the programmers fixed it, or the map designers fixed it. I can't really say for sure, but that is a practice of mine. When they are sunken in, I cut a few limbs off and go out and come back in. And usually the trees will pop out, and then you can cut them all down and, well, mostly chip them, because they're not spruce, well, what I call spruce, some people call them pine, but pine needles are longer. Well, I'm not going to get into that, they're just trees, right? Evergreens, some people will call them. Let's stick with that. Like this stand over here, if I want, or just on my left here, they could be cleared out with the T-Rex and do it fast. I could cut them down, chop them up into liftable, manageable pieces, and chip them. The question is time and money. If I have time, but with all the contract work and getting this field done, I don't know if I'm going to have time to do that. I'm thinking about taking out a small loan. Maybe moving things along for you viewers. Don't want you getting bored watching me go round and round and round the same field for months on end. So, I'm thinking about taking out a loan. I know in my mind it's cheating a little bit, but like I said, now that I'm producing YouTube videos, I have to think about what the my watchers, if I have any. I have to think about what they might enjoy. I know I won't please everyone. I try my best, and that's what I do. It's all I can do. Try my best. Some of you may get an idea. Perhaps I will spark a inspiration in some player, and for me that would be good enough. Some younger viewers or people first to starting out in the what do we call this? The PlayStation 4 farming simulator. Some of them might gain insight into something I say. Like I said before, that's good enough for me. So I think I'll go around twice on this piece, and then turn it over to the hired hand. I'm thinking also, on top of that loan, I want a different combine, so I'm thinking of selling my combine. I'm also thinking of, let me see if I can manage this. I think we will, so I can explain a plan that has formulated in my mind, and over that, okay. Yeah, in the last little while, we'll set this guy on automatic here, or hired hand, or whatever you want to call it. Right now, soybeans are at 1466, which is the highest paying. And I, right now, I'm in 69 on a contract job. I've been looking around. Here's a soybean field. I could buy that for 140. So if I take out a small loan, I could buy that and get a nice crop of soybeans and take them to market. That's no, I can get in this way. That is just up the road. And can I get in there? Yeah, so that's what I'm thinking. This will move it along without actually cheating too much. I had planned on buying these fields as my main farm, the fields around. Animals, they will pop up if you buy these other see, dairy farm, but there's no barn icon, so you actually have to buy it first, but that would leave me so spread out. That stud, I imagine that's horse. What are we down here? Instead of having my animals all spread all over the place, I can grab a small field like 52 or 43, 42, and place my plowing there. Place my mods for cattle, or even the in-game ones. So that's the plan. Might require me to take out a small loan, or I could haul my canola into, what is that, Seven Valley store. That'll be selling it low, but it will make up the price of 48 if I sell my combine too, and the header, and lease a combine and header. Yeah. Well, that'll come. Oh, this guy is stuck. That will come later. Right now I want to get this field going. I still have to do the head then, lime it, fertilize it. And I had to get that contract in 69 on the go again too. Those trees took a, what is it, an hour or so game time to clean up a little bit. I wanted to see if my theory of the trees popping out of the ground would work, but apparently not. So I will cut trunks, hang on to the T-Rex to clean up the stumps, and maybe chip them. There is the what's it called, the chipper that sends them directly to the mill. And right now wood chips at the mill are, that's a good price for wood chips, 1400 I think it was. No, 1165 and going up. I'm not sure if that wood chipper, the in-game one, will. Let's see if I can find it quickly here. Wrong thing. I think it's under miscellaneous. Yeah, there it is, Jensen. I'm missing anything. It's a little more difficult running the YouTube. I can run all this through my mind, but now I have to, with you people watching, I have to explain what I'm thinking and how my mind works. Well, I could take who knows how long. Like I mentioned at the start, I think you make a plan, but it's not written in stone. That field 48 is going to help a lot because soybeans are so high right now, and that will earn me a lot of income. And it was part of the plan, just, shall we say, I moved it up a little bit. I mean, I would have worked my way across. 51, 50, and then what, 49, 48, 40, whatever, work across. But jumping over a few fields, I feel it's not cheating in any way. I know a lot of people want, as I said before, want to be as realistic as possible. Well, as realistic as the game will allow. I think I mentioned before about generic seed. One seed for all, well, just about all crops and other things. That's, yeah, no need to cover that again. You would drive programmers crazy probably if they had to write code for so many different things. I wonder, the mods, I wonder if I could go in and, because if you can, make mods, what would they let me do with seeds and other things? Maybe make some of the, logging, machines a little better. Of course they are. Some of them are, or most of them are pretty good. Scorpion King, I love that. What is it, log forks for the big loader. The beak, definitely underpowered, I've noticed. Let's see, this guy's going. I can jump over here. I shouldn't have done that. I should have walked. Oh well. I gotta take this. I'll get the T-Rex on this. tree here and get it out of the way after I think I'm gonna sell some stuff here and buy that field. So we will dump this. That contract going. That'll earn me a little more money. Maybe I won't have to take my canola in. Okay, let's figure something out here. Yeah, I want to sell here just to take way too long to do a field. You're too small to haul, and you, I wanna, don't need you right now. And there's my field. So, we will, do this, buy 48. Okay, and, I want my, get that contract going. So I will head up north. What does that feel? Oh, I won't be able to tell until I soil composition. Oh, it needs lime. Plowing around the edges. I think I sent that lime machine back, didn't I? Somebody's blocked. Who is operating? Okay. My fertilizer spreader's in the way. And you are a leased tractor, so we don't want you sitting around doing nothing. That's just throwing money in the... throwing money to the wind. That's what that is. That's right, so... you going. Actually, thanks. I will ride up, save me walking a little bit. So, yeah, I'm gonna have to check what kind of combine can I get here. Matt, 2001. I'm gonna lease. Better go small here. I hope that field is flat. What are we? I got $5,000. I need 15. Yeah, 15 plus the header. So we're looking at... what are we looking at? 58, huh? Oh, no. Yeah. 15. And 2, 7, 3. We're going to call that 8. Okay. Okay, thanks for the ride, buddy. Yeah, get up to 69, get that going. Try to get that combine leased. Could get run over here pretty easy. Not really a sidewalk here, is there? Okay, what are we after? Going to need a cart to, haul down that or my canola to the sell point, so I will lease you and I will use this tractor. But first I gotta get that Well, I can hold on to this tractor as long as, where's the end of this? That contract stays open. As long as that stays open, I have use of that tractor to haul my canola to market. So, that's good. So, let's get this rocking and rolling here. I have a little timer here. Actually, a timer on my phone, which I have forgotten to turn on, so if this video turns out short, that will be the reason. I don't want to run over and have a lot missing from your viewing pleasure. Okay, you take a walk down there and get that canola going. That'll have to earn me money for my to lease that combine. I don't think there's that much. 35,000. Let's see. This button. Canola. Oh, I got 44,000. Okay, where is this? Okay, I think I know where that is. I just hope this tractor can pull. This will give me a chance to check on the seeder, make sure he's working properly. If this works out, maybe I could just use a T-Rex to chew up mulch all the trees and not bother chipping them. It would earn me more money, but we're looking at time here, time saving. If I wasn't YouTubing, I might indulge. Because once this field is done, the only thing I have to do then will be contract work. I won't have to use the hired man, because I can do all that myself. Where am I headed? Oh yeah, I'm headed for my... load up a canoe and take it Seven Valley. Yeah, my memory's not that great. That's from old age memory era, yeah. Old age. Could be Alzheimer's, you never know. I think I've forgotten whether it's Alzheimer's or not. Okay, canola, where are you? There you go. I think this holds 31,000. I like this silo, it fills fast. Fills the cart fast. So that is, yeah, 31. Take two trips. But at least the next harvest I take off, I won't be running back and forth and back and forth so much. Save time. Save time in the field and save fuel. Well, in real life. less time you're spending in the field, less the fuel you're burning, and yeah. Small, another thing, small implements, everybody's so conscious now about compaction of the ground. Smaller implements you're running over the same ground more and more and more times, so yeah. Bigger machinery is good. I mean, you could buy yourself a mower and plow every year, which is what we did. So we had smaller machinery. Well, in Ontario, it was a practice back in those days to plow your fields. Yeah, well, you know, crop rotation. Hay field to corn, corn to grain, grain to hay. It's pretty much how we hay field the last couple of years, depending on how well your hay was seeded. If it took, yeah, well, once again, I won't bore you with a lot of unnecessary details. Real life farming. You could probably find all that online. My personal experience, I guess, is I could talk about that, but that's long hours in the field. That's what I grew up. One of my earliest memories is 6 years old. We bailed small bales onto a wagon. What the farm girl does the same thing there. Yeah, I think she does. There's a YouTuber that they do that still. So if you're interested, you could look that up. 6 years old I was, and what I would do is I would drag the bales back on the wagon until the wagon was full, and then my father would come and stack them. So yeah, that was my one of my first memories. Well, among many, I mean. Okay, let's see if we can, whoops, let's do this properly. Big difference from backing up this way and backing up in real life. Okay, what do we got? Oh yeah, we definitely got enough lease our combine and header. Get out of the way so I can see. Okay. So let's wonder, should I bother dragging any more down? I'll get a little bit from that contract. And if I harvest that, yeah, okay, so we're gonna get our combine rocking here, at least one anyway. And we shall make a few dollars, I won't have to take out a loan after all. That will be good. Of course, my my leased inventory is going to hurt me at midnight, but I took a baling contract and well, it was a square baler, and then you had to rewrap it. I have the new, what is it, Vicon baler that you don't have to stop. Wraps the bale and you can keep going. The other one's in game. The Kloss and the, what is it, Clune, I believe. Both of those you have to stop where you skip over hay. Leave that hay lane. Okay, what are we doing here? contract goes, is I think that Combine's gonna be blinking as he's full. I think the suits are still running. Excuse me. Yeah, he's still going strong. Possibility I drank too much coffee this morning. Okay. Maybe I can lease a bigger combine if I earn enough money from this. Maybe that's what I should do. Yeah, I can see the combine, the hill is spout his own, so. Get out here without getting run over. Oh yeah, I gotta go on the other side of the road, don't I? Okay, here we go. I wonder what the posted speed limit is on here. Never mind. I think I saw one. It's not Germany, so it's not the Autobahn. I speed limit. Or maybe this is England. I think this map is in England. Or this place. Pretty sure it is. Of course, every European map. What's this? It's not a speed limit, I don't think. Most of the European maps I've looked at so far, the roads are narrow. I find them narrow. I'm used to nice wide out here in British Columbia. Well, actually from Kenora, which is the Manitoba-Ontario border. The shoulders are paved. Ontario, Quebec, I don't think they... well, I know Ontario doesn't... or at least they didn't in the past pave their shoulders. But the western provinces do, I guess maybe because we have less roads to pave, maybe. The prairie, well, they pave some roads, but a lot of the back roads, shall we call them, are not paved, just gravel. British Columbia does not have a ton of roads, but we do have some. Okay, that's got to be Helper F. That's got to be the Cedar. And I know he's not complete. Completed his task, so I don't know what's up with that. That's a long drive. So I think, what should I do here? Time-wise, I don't want to run over. I think maybe once I get my... I can't, so there's no cover. I'll have to drive to the end. So none gets spilled. Normally, whenever you cover your wagon, it's a signal for the combine to stop loading you and swing his auger back in. But this thing does not have a cover. did get a covered one. I think it'd be too big for these new. Well, it'd make it harder to maneuver. This is a nice size. It's not small like some of them, and it's not huge. So mid-range, I guess you could call it. And here we go. That's 1466. Of course, so this load will come coming from the field. Helper B is blocked, but what is up? I guess maybe I should cut ahead then for this guy. Yeah, he stopped. I don't know why. Hedgerow, I guess? Okay, we'll cut you ahead down here, fella. Keep you from messing up. I'm surprised he did the first ones. First few runs, okay. Don't know why he can't make it now. Very unusual. He's far enough away from that telephone pole, I think. And if they run into trouble, they usually still run. They just sit there and wait for the hired man, wait for somebody with brains to come along and fix the thing. But we shall. Okay, and while I'm doing this, 27. How big a combine can I get for 27 lease for 27,000? 15, you're gonna work. Yeah, that's what I'm driving right now. Maybe I get get the international. What is it? 73, I think, on Melbourne Farms. Number float. Okay, let's see what we got here. And where's the international? 29.4 or 92.40, and that bad boy is 21 to lease. And I think that's getting into the big flex head. It's not my cloth Linux, but that should work. Maybe I should stick with this smaller one. Maybe these fields aren't that big, but be harder maneuvering the bigger header around. Well, it is lease, so I could try it. But I'm not committed until I actually buy something. So maybe I will give the international a try. And I hold around a 45-foot header. Yeah, that might represent some problems in corners. If I have a 90-degree corner, could. Maybe we better stick with the smaller one. Take longer, but make less problems, maybe. I'll try the smaller one first and see how that goes. I think it's too easy getting into the field and whatever, then maybe go for one of the bigger ones. big, whoops, I let the header, it's on wheels, but still, it's hard in the throat, and a tight turn. Small gentle turn is not so bad, but back on the straight and narrow. I can haul this. I know I was gonna check out combines. Yeah, maybe I should leave this guy here. And well, I'm taking my combine over to the new field, what is it, 38, I think? 48? Something I bought, anyway. I can, or this guy could be finishing up this field, and then I'll have everything in this car taken down. Yeah, that's a plan. Kind of off the cuff. Okay, I'm gonna stay out of that hedge road. I cut across the field here and get to the shop, sales yard, sales whatever, blah blah blah. Okay, I guess I should apologize for my breathing in previous videos, and actually this one too maybe, but I spent too many years in cedar sawmills. I think I mentioned this before. I'll turn that off. Excuse me again. Too many years in cedar mills, and cedar dust is highly toxic. So it has attacked my lungs, and on this side of the fence, I have developed asthma. Pretty bad, and now there's smoke from fires in California and different areas. Let's see, what am I doing here? 625, 14, 10, 14, 400. Yeah, I think we will 10. This is the one I'm operating now, I think. Comes with the shorter header. Okay, you're 15. Wheel wide tires. Yeah. Gets me up higher. And we are leasing you. And we want a header. There it is. Draper Stream 900. Okay, 9 meters wide. That's not too bad. It's not what I. Okay, that's 900. Let's see. Draper Stream 900. Still 9. That's my go-to with the Lennox. Okay, did I go by it? I think I went by it. Ah, here we go. Smaller header. And, oh. Okay. Let's get that, soybeans, what field number is it? Can't remember, 48. Okay. In the past, I have, if I have a contract in a field right beside the one I owned, I would take, ooh. But I noticed that they've changed that now. You cannot use a contract combine to do your own fields. They, or at least on this map, in the past I have used contract if it was close by. I just would not pull the contract until I had my field gun. Now, if I recall right, this young lad in the cedar has stopped for some strange reason. And I need that field planted because, well, it's getting late in the day and it still needs to be lined and fertilized.